This is why California's high-speed rail is a huge disaster. Luxury megaprojects. We're going to look at one of the most controversial transportation projects in America today, California's high-speed rail. You may wonder why a transportation project sparks so much debate and opposition. The answer is simple. It's been a major disaster. Yes, you heard that right. On paper, it was a game-changing investment in the state's future, promising to revolutionize transport and connect key cities in unprecedented ways. However, the reality has been quite different. Many others are calling it a total and utter disaster. Despite years of planning and billions of dollars invested, this project has been plagued by delays, cost overruns, and many other concerns, leaving Californians scratching their heads and wondering what went wrong. In this video, we'll look at why California's high-speed rail has been such a catastrophic disaster and what it implies for the future of transportation in the Golden State. But before that, give a luxury touch to the like, share, and subscribe icons. Let's get started. California, which has a population of around 40 million and a total GDP of $3.4 trillion, is the biggest, most important, and most powerful state in the United States. Los Angeles and the San Francisco Bay Area are California's two biggest engines, with 13 million and 8 million residents, respectively. Traveling between these two cities has always been difficult, with a normal journey lasting at least 6 hours. To meet California's ever-increasing emissions targets, the state began investigating the potential of including a better, more logical third choice between cities, high-speed rail. This would be substantially faster than driving between the two major cities and a cheaper option to flying, with multiple stops along the way to further connect and serve even more of California's population. California's plan for a 220-mile-an-hour high-speed rail line is a game-changing idea that would connect cities, increase the economy, reduce emissions, and usher the world's sole superpower into the high-speed club presently controlled by China. California voters approved a plan to create a high-speed rail line 14 years ago, but the project is already over budget and many years behind schedule. This is owing to the lack of high-speed rail lines in the nation, such as the Osola Express, which can transport people in 2 hours and 45 minutes, while averaging 82 miles an hour when all stops are taken into account. However, progress on the route has been nowhere as quick and efficient as the trains it intends to operate one day. The idea is to connect the areas of Southern California, the San Joaquin Valley, and San Francisco Bay, giving a faster and cleaner method to travel between them, while also enhancing the local economy and minimizing harm to agricultural and protected lands along the way. This is an inside look at California's lengthy, difficult, and incredible fight to build America's first high-speed rail line. The California High-Speed Rail Authority is in charge of the initiative to develop an 800-mile high-speed rail network. Phase 1 entails constructing a line from San Francisco to Los Angeles via the Central Valley, which will subsequently continue to Anaheim. Phase 2 will stretch from Los Angeles to San Diego with a branch from Merced to Sacramento. The halfway segment, a 119-mile corridor from Madera to Bakersfield, is now under construction, with 35 separate sites active. The San Joaquin River Viaduct superstructure is a bridge on the boundary of Fresno and Madera counties that will serve as the new entry point into the Central Valley. While there has been significant improvement, it does not compensate for the numerous setbacks that continue to cause delays and raise expenses. Since 2008, the California High-Speed Rail Authority has faced challenges. Originally priced at $33 billion in 2008, the total number is now anticipated to be more than $100 billion, with no completion date until at least 2029. Property acquisition has also been a problem, with hundreds of lots required to obtain a 65-mile portion of the property in Kings County near Fresno. Construction on the route has already begun, which is not ideal. The Central Valley Line is only a sliver of the whole system, and critical links to Los Angeles and San Francisco are still in the works. Some have called the project a train to nowhere, since it will only serve the Central Valley, where most of the construction is being done. Even California Governor Gavin Newsom attacked the whole project's plans for 2019, claiming it would be too expensive and take too long. The decision to hire certain contractors has been questioned, and one business that claimed $300 million in savings by changing plans for the Kings County section ended up costing the project $800 million in overruns. The Rail Authority has sped up building on the starting system, but at the present expenditure rate of $1.8 million per day. The train will not be finished this century. Despite this, it is difficult to miss the benefits that this initiative would bring if it were eventually finished. the California High-Speed Rail Project has faced significant obstacles due to its location, which necessitates long and costly tunnels across its active seismic zones. Furthermore, California has the country's second highest average real estate values, making the expense of purchasing and obtaining property for the train prohibitively expensive. According to the World Bank, the total expense of California's high-speed rail system per kilometer in 2014 was around $56 million, which is greater than that in other countries such as China, where the cost is more like $19 million, or almost one-third of the price. Since its start, the project has struggled to obtain sufficient property, and there are still more than 200 parcels of land that the railway needs to acquire to capture a 52-mile portion in Kings County to complete the Central Bakersfield-Merced segment. In 2008, the California High-Speed Rail Authority claimed to voters that the project would reduce motor traffic across all of California's highways and roads to the extent of 400 billion miles of vehicle travel inside the state. However, 14 years later, the total cost of just the 500-mile-long Phase 1 of the systems connecting San Francisco to Los Angeles and Anaheim has risen to at least $105 billion, making it California's largest single investment and one of America's most ambitious civil engineering projects ever. The initial estimate was based on outdated assumptions, therefore the final cost will most likely be higher. Many private investors have questioned the train's competitiveness with airplanes between San Francisco and Los Angeles, fearing that most Californians will continue to prefer flying over riding the rail. The Trump administration canceled roughly $1 billion in government financing for the railway in 2019, citing concerns with construction delays and financial overruns. The Biden administration passed an infrastructure bill in 2021 that gave Amtrak $66 billion to expand the SLA Express in the Northeast and build out new services across the country, but it did not include any specifically designated funding for California's high-speed rail project. According to Tom Richards, a developer from Fresno in the Central Valley, project leaders have worked through the problems and have a plan that would connect 85% of California's people to a quick, efficient rail system. However, major Democratic leaders in the legislature, as well as Governor Gavin Newsom, are raising concerns about allocating more public funding. Many in California's government are concerned that once the central segment between Bakersfield and Merced is completed, at a cost of around $23 billion, the state will struggle to find the funding needed to complete the estimated $50 billion leg from Bakersfield to Los Angeles, which requires lengthy and expensive mountain tunnels and a $22 billion lake. The United States has approved a $2 trillion infrastructure plan with around $20 billion dedicated to intercity rail. California's high-speed line is the first to open, but there are proposals for a route between Dallas and Houston and a line between Victorville and Las Vegas, and private investors are looking at prospective projects in Florida and Maryland. America's first high-speed rail line is still years away, contrasting sharply with what's happening in competitive nations such as China, although in a different culture and political system. Two-thirds of the world's total high-speed rail network is located here, and Europeans aren't bad either. If the California High-Speed Railway Project is completed, it could provide enormous potential benefits to the millions of citizens of California, but it is struggling against challenges including geography, economics, demographics, America's own cultural and historic preferences for cars and planes, the legal system, and more, making its ultimate future uncertain. And that brings us to the end of today's video. From the ambitious goal of linking Northern and Southern California with a high-speed railway system to the current state of delays, cost overruns, and political strife, it's evident that this project has been a huge disaster. While the future of high-speed rail remains unknown, one thing is certain: it will require significant effort and collaboration from all stakeholders to become a reality. Also, remember that this isn't just a story about a failed transportation project. It's also a lesson on the need for proper planning, accountability, and transparency in any big public infrastructure project. To prevent repeating high-speed rail failures, we must expect more from our government officials and hold them accountable for the judgments they make. Thank you for watching the video. What do you think about the future of high-speed rail in California? Drop your thoughts down below in the comments section. Don't forget to like and share this video with your friends and family, and be sure to subscribe to our channel, Luxury Mega Projects, for more similar content. Until next time, goodbye!